Hey everyone, and welcome back to my channel. Today I'm going to be sharing my full-time working mom morning routine, and today I am by myself. My name is Kilee, and I have two girls who are 3 and 7. I work full-time as a manager for a corporate restaurant, hello crazy hours, and my husband travels for work 6 months out of the year. If you're not subscribed to my channel, I'd love it if you do that now. I like to share videos about our life and what it's like to be a working mom. We start out our mornings at around 6:15. Cold brew, this cozy robe, and lots of free planning are a must to get us through the mornings. I like to plan out everything for the day the night before. Tell me, do you work or do you stay at home? Both definitely have their own set of challenges, that's for sure. Before we leave the house, it's important that I check to make sure everyone has everything. We have a babysitter that picks up the kids from preschool and after school care because I don't get off work until about 8:30. She makes them dinner and takes them to dance, so I have to make sure to send everything they need for the day with them. Today, Cadence has dance after school. I usually leave post-it notes with what's for dinner and what chores need to be done after school on the fridge for everyone. Try to get out the door by 7:15. First Cadence gets dropped off, then Callie, and then I head to the gym. All right, kids are at school, car seats at school. Now I'm gonna go to the gym. It's 7:45, so my goal was to be at the gym by 7:45, but I think I'm gonna be there by like 8:15. And then I'm gonna have like 45 minutes to work out until 9, and then I have 30 minutes to get ready, and then I have to be at work. So, 45 minutes is better than no minutes. I'm gonna come in the middle of this morning routine to just say what's up, hello. I'm driving to the gym right now, and I'm gonna talk a little bit about what I do to keep my ish together in the mornings. So I don't actually work every morning like this. This is only like once or twice a week because I am a restaurant manager, so my schedule varies. Like sometimes I work in the morning and sometimes I work in the evening. So the mornings that I have to open the restaurant like today are pretty hectic because I gotta get both kids to school, and then obviously most of the time my husband is gone because he works out of town for half the time. So that's kind of rough. On these mornings, I like to pick my battles, and I think that that's like the biggest thing that helps me out. For example, the kids always eat breakfast at school on mornings like this. Callie's school provides all of her food, and then Cadence's school has free breakfast, so they eat breakfast there. It cuts down a whole like ordeal at the house. I always have them pick out their clothes ahead of time, or I pick out their clothes, and then I always have Cadence's lunch ready to go, and I try to just have everything ready ahead of time. We do have a babysitter that will be picking them up from school this evening because I probably won't be off before their after school program closes, and Cadence has dance. So it's a lot of like switching around car seats and moving things around, and it can be kind of a lot, but the more I can get done ahead of time, the better my morning goes. And I am not a morning person. I don't like to get up early, so I've gotta like really set myself up for success. Otherwise, I'm gonna be like super grumpy. Opening mornings are long days for me. I like to start the day off on a positive note, so I like to have everything ready to go. That's my little tips for you guys. Obviously, if you work or you like have something big to do in the morning, it's very important and helpful to just be super ready and have everything good to go, so there's very little to do in the morning. It gives me more time to just like be calm and get coffee and chill, and I can do their hair instead of like fighting them about breakfast and stuff. Another thing that we struggle with is food for dinner. So I have to leave out something for the babysitter to cook. Obviously, I don't want her to have to come up with dinner. I always just like put out something super easy. And obviously that doesn't mean that it's always the healthiest, but again, picking your battles for something like this is really important. Obviously, if I'm cooking dinner, I can make a really healthy, like homemade from scratch dinner, even though I don't really like to cook, but you know what I mean. But I don't want to put any more on myself than I have to, so I just, like on the nights where babysitters are picking them up, I come up with something pretty easy and I just call it a day. I've decided to no longer feel guilty for things like that because obviously I have a very hectic life, but what my kids are gonna remember about it is how I handle it. And if I have to do things like make them, you know, have mac and cheese for dinner versus like homemade food, they're not gonna remember that. Like, they are not gonna care, but they are gonna remember that like I wasn't super stressed out. So I think lowering stress is the most important thing when it comes to being busy or like solo momming it. If your partner works far away or like they're not there to help you much, don't stress yourself out about like doing fancy little things. Like, just do what's easy to put you in a good mood, because how you react is gonna be how your kids react, and they're gonna feed off of your energy. So if you have good positive energy in the morning, they're gonna have like a good positive day. So whatever you got to do to make yourself have good positive energy, even if it's serving your kid chicken nuggets and waffles, then do what you gotta do, you know? So don't feel guilty for that. I feel like a lot of times moms get wrapped up in the little things that we see on Instagram. We think we should be doing like cooking friggin' homemade breakfast and fancy little lunches and stuff like that, which all of that is well and good if you have the time, but it doesn't have to be an everyday thing. Sometimes you just gotta pick your battles and get through the day and put yourself in a good mood and make your life easier. You can't get wrapped up in the details because your kids aren't really gonna remember all of those little things. They'll actually remember it better if you just do it once in a while. So yeah, I love to make fancy little breakfasts and homemade dinners and fancy lunchbox meals. And I like to, you know, wake up before the birds in the morning and brew coffee by hand, but I don't always do that. You know, like sometimes we gotta eat waffles and call it a day. That's my little soapbox rant for this morning. And I'm about to head to the gym. I can't vlog in the gym. Well, I guess I could, but I just feel weird vlogging in the gym because people are like trying to do stuff, and I don't wanna be like that. So I probably won't vlog in the gym, but I'm gonna go to the gym and I'm gonna get ready at the gym, and then I'll see you guys after that.
One hour later.
Forgot my hair tie. Hoping I have one in here. I got like 10 minutes until I gotta be at work. It's not that serious. Okay, lipstick on. Ready to go to work. Let's go. All right, so I just pulled up at work, found a hair tie, so I'm gonna go inside and do my hair because it's looking a little cray cray. This is yesterday's hair. But this concludes my morning routine, because now I'm about to go into work, and that's gonna be the rest of my day until I get off this evening and go home. So hope you guys enjoy this morning routine. If you have any questions for me, post them down below, and I will see you guys in my next video. If you're not subscribed to my channel, do that now. It would be a great time. I like to keep it real over here. I like to hang out with you guys, and I like to show you my life. So hit that subscribe button if you're not. Comments, questions, whatever, you know where to put it. I'll see you guys next time. Have a great day.